Today, what rights do tenants have without a lease? Hello again. So what do you do when you have a tenant that doesn't have a lease? Or if you are a tenant, what rights do you as a tenant have without a lease? So my name's Mike Slane. I am the discount property investor. Purchased over 150 rental properties in the past, I'd say 3 or 4 years. Sold a few, hold quite a few. And again, I'm gonna try to answer some of these questions for you. So today, what rights do tenants have without a lease? I like to answer these questions first from the perspective of a tenant, and then I'll talk about it from the perspective of the landlord. And again, I always encourage people to treat people fairly and do what's right in the situation. Okay, so as a tenant, what are your rights? So if you're renting a property and you don't have a lease, you do have several rights. It depends on your state's laws, so you always have to kind of look at your specific state. I know that's kind of a challenge, but for people, especially when everything's online and everywhere, it's hard to answer that question very, very specifically for each state. So if you do have state-specific questions, let me know and I can try to answer those if I know the answer or if I can find it for you. But what a tenant is referred to if they are not, if they do not have a lease, they're considered a tenant at will. So that is, again, someone who doesn't have a lease, and that can actually be somewhat advantageous to you depending on the situation. So what happens if you don't have a lease? You're considered to have an implied lease if it's not in writing, and if you have like an oral arrangement with the landlord, meaning you said or you spoke with each other and agreed that $700 a month or $800 a month would be fair, and you've been doing this for several months. That is an implied lease. So again, if you can produce evidence of that, most people would say, yes, that was probably agreed to. So if you want to move out, then how do you terminate the implied lease? Well, you should give notice to your landlord, again, because you don't want them to come and, you know, if you leave and 3 months later, they knock on the door and say, hey, where's my rent for the past 3 months? And you aren't there. They could say, well, you should have paid rent for the past 3 months. So again, you want to give notice and let the landlord know that you're going to be moving out. And typically, the period is the length of time you should give notice. So if you're paying once a month, you should give a month's notice. If you're paying every 2 weeks, 2 weeks is probably going to suffice in that situation. The security deposit, now this one can be a challenge if you do not have a lease. So again, I always recommend that you get a lease in writing, even as a tenant. It helps protect you, and if you've given someone money as a security deposit and you didn't damage anything, it's going to be very difficult for you to prove that without something in writing, receipt at the minimum. So again, document that from a tenant's perspective. You guys need to do that. Landlord's perspective makes the most sense. Get everything in writing. What can happen regarding an eviction? Your landlord usually can give you 30 days notice, and then you're expected to leave. With regards to eviction, so it's basically a 30 days notice. It's a rent or quit is going to have to be filed. I'm going to answer that a little bit further here in the next section here when I talk about what the tenant's rights are and how a tenant sees or a landlord sees this situation. So how can a landlord lawfully evict someone without a lease? It's a little bit more challenging because, again, you're going to run into problems with the courts because there's no lease and you can't really necessarily prove anything. But there are legal rights to help you remedy it. And again, you don't want to break any laws because if you do, the court can then kind of rule in the tenant's favor. So you don't want to evict someone for any unlawful reasons like race, religion, anything like that. Or if they complain about something on the property, or again, trying to evict them without a court order, turning off utilities to try to squeeze them out, things like that, don't do it. You can evict, though, if the property is unsafe, if the lease has expired, if they're not paying back rent, if a tenant doesn't pay, guys, you can get evicted. Landlords, you have every right to evict them. If there's illegal drug use reported or criminal activity being reported on the property that you're made aware of, those again are reasons that you can evict someone. So with this in mind, you want to make sure you are going through all the steps to evict someone. So first you want to serve a tenant with an official notice to quit with the proper waiting period. So what's a notice to quit? This is an official way to let the tenant know that they need to leave the property and when. If a tenant refuses to leave after that period, if the lease is in force and it's over, that's generally the notice to quit. A notice to quit is only legally valid if there's confirmation that the tenant received it. So you're going to want to send a certified mail or a letter by certified mail so that that you can prove that the tenant received that notice to quit. Okay, so file the notice to quit. And again, that's a certified letter saying your lease is up, need you to get out on this date. Next step is then you actually file for eviction with the local court. If the tenant doesn't want to move, if they've stayed after they've received the notice to quit, then you want to make sure you keep all your documentation so that you can bring it to court with you and give the reasons why you want the tenant to move, when the tenant acquired the property, and why you need them to leave, especially if it's prior to the end of a formal lease. Now again, if it's just a tenant without a lease, again, bring everything you've got. Make sure you've got your notice to quit, confirmation the tenant received it, and again, bring all your documents related to rent that they've paid, rent they haven't paid, etc. If there's any criminal charges or drug use or damage to the property, document that, bring that into the court as well. So then if the court rules in your favor, they're going to issue an eviction notice, and then you can contact the sheriff to come and help you remove the tenant at that time. Again, no one wants to get to that point. It's always not a fun situation, but that sometimes happens. Another option, what I always recommend trying first, is cash for keys. And this one is, it's painful. If a tenant owes you back rent for 2 months, 3 months, you're basically going to say, hey, listen, you're never going to catch up. We both know that. I'll give you $500 if you can be out by the end of the week. Something along those lines. Basically, just get out of my house so that I can get this thing turned over. I'm willing to let go of this back rent, and you know, I need to rent this property so I can make money. So it's basically a very hard lesson to learn as a landlord when you have to do the cash for keys thing. You are kind of letting that back rent go. You can't file for the damages. You can't actually send that to collections, but it is another approach that a lot of people use. I've used it in the past with problem tenants. And again, it does. It usually motivates people that don't want to leave your property. So cash for keys is another option for tenants. So that is the discussion on what rights do tenants have without a lease kind of steers more towards, tenants have rights. They definitely have the ability to stay in a property, especially if they are paying rent routinely. It's an implied lease. They're considered a tenant at will. But they can be evicted from a landlord's perspective if they stop paying rent or are doing something bad to the property, or again, not paying rent, which is an issue. So that's pretty much it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Again, my name's Mike Slane, the Discount Property Investor. Please like, share, and subscribe if this video helped you or if you learned anything today. Subscribe to the channel. I do a lot of videos like this where I talk about landlord issues and tenant issues. And we've got a whole program on how I acquired my rental properties, my portfolio. It's called the Free Landlord Course. And it shows you how we applied the Burr method to acquire rental properties with little to none of our own money. Thank you guys so much. Take care. We'll see you on the next one.